Welcome back. It's the million-dollar question that kids around the country ask every year. Just how does the big man do it?
Do the reindeer and their magic food power the sleigh, or is it down to Santa's wizardry? Mm. Well, I went on my own journey to try and get some answers. Have a look. Mm. Well, I'm on a special mission today to find out how Santa's sleigh works and just where the magic comes from. So my first port of call is Miss Hassett's senior infants class here at St. Lawrence's School in Greystones in County Wicklow. Jacob, I believe you have an interesting theory about how the sleigh flies on Christmas Eve all around the world. Will you tell us about that?
So the reindeers have magic and then the sleigh gets lighter because the magic connects to the sleigh.
The magic connects to the sleigh. So it's actually the reindeer who have the magic, not Santa, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. And how does he get around the whole world?
The reindeers, because
the reindeers get more dust every year, so they can fly around as much as they want when Santa wants them to.
When Santa gets in, and the Rudolph gets attached to some rope, and then the Rudolph runs, and then he flies up in the sky.
So there's actually no engine in the sleigh because it's like the reindeers are the engine, and then the reindeers have these magic oats.
Wow.
That they have, and then they have, I think, water.
And what do the magic oats look like?
I think they're like ordinary oats, things like...
Like porridge?
Yeah.
Okay. And someone said they have magic dust in them.
Yeah, I think that they put magic dust in. Most magic dust is the main ingredient.
I want to leave out cookie and mince pie and a drink of milk.
And a drink of milk. That sounds lovely. Can I come to your house for those snacks?
No.
Maybe Santa puts the dust on the reindeers and they are clipped into something and it pulls the sleigh into the air.
And will you leave out some snacks for Santa?
I leave out a snack pack.
Oh, what's a snack pack?
There's water and there's things to eat.
Oh, sounds lovely. Can I come to your house for a snack pack? How?
Because he's magic.
No, he's a little mom, can't you see? So it's your to sleep in your lovely sheep and forget about the mystery.
Well, the children in my class know that Santa's Robin has been keeping a close eye and they have to be very good in school and for mummies and daddies. Isn't that right, boys and girls?
Yeah. Yes.
And most importantly, they have to go to bed very early on Christmas Eve.
Well, over 30 million passengers will have passed through Dublin Airport this year alone. But there's one special visitor that the authorities here at Dublin Airport are eagerly awaiting.
That's too strong, 'cause it is my favourite holiday. But all this year's been a busy blur, don't think I have...
Siobhan, the airport, always a very busy time at Christmas in particular, but special preparations for a real VIP guest.
Absolutely. You can see the main runway here just beside us. We're overlooking it here. Last year, when the reindeers landed and the sleigh landed, they actually damaged the runway. We could see there were hoof marks in the runway, and there was such a heavy landing with so many presents coming to Ireland. So we've been repairing the runway over the year to make sure that it's going to be in tip-top shape for when he lands on Christmas Eve. And we're super excited with it. We've been in touch with the aviation elves. They've come out and they've had an inspection of the runway. We're not there yet, but we're almost there, and we're really confident that the runway will be absolutely perfect at Christmas time. Out on the airfield, if anybody's driving by, if the boys and girls are out with their parents, they'll see all the tractors and snowplows that are out around the airfield. So that's another side of the preparation that we have for Christmas Eve. So we're really, really confident that no matter what happens on Christmas Eve that we have all the tools and the equipment out on the airfield ready to keep the operation open. Nothing is going to stop Santa coming to Dublin Airport on Christmas Eve.
Now, this guy doesn't seem to have any answers for me, but I have arrived here at UCD Explore and our scientist Philip is going to talk me through what flying is all about, because of course this is our question today. How does Santa fly around the world? And it seems you guys are trying to figure it out too.
Yeah, and it's a great question, because if we can figure that out, maybe we could try and do it ourselves. So we started looking about, well, where does he do it? He does that in midair, so let's try and start looking at air. So it was a very simple experiment to start out with. We have two bottles,
okay.
One with water,
one with air in top, and there's a hole in between the two. So what do you think is going to happen when I turn this upside down?
The water will flow through.
Okay, well, if we do that, the water doesn't. It gets stuck up the top. And the reason for this is because air has mass. It takes up space. So it means that you can push stuff in it, or you can push other stuff. The hole is still there. You can make it and do a snazzy trick if you want.
But make it for the space to go air up or move it up and down. But what we're learning from this is that air has stuff inside it, mass, that you can move things with, like hair or anything else like that.
Okay.
So if we know that, we can exploit it, we can use it.
Yes.
So there is a principle that we use called Bernoulli's principle, and this is actually how planes fly. So Bernoulli said that air traveling fast creates an area of low pressure. So if you create an area of low pressure the way the wings are designed, that causes it to lift. The push of air against the wing combined with that makes planes lift, because planes are attached to wings.
Okay.
So if you've got fast moving air, you can make things levitate or float in midair.
So if you have something that's simple, that works really well, you can make it bigger, on a bigger scale. So what I have is a bigger hairdryer, and we're gonna see if we can get this to work.
This is a serious hairdryer, isn't it?
Yeah, well, we've a lot
of hair. Throw it up?
You ready? No, just hold it. So we've got something cool, and by cool, I mean really cool.
Very cool.
Very cool. So in here, you can see we've got something really cold. So in your fridge, you've got stuff ice that's about -4 degrees. In here, we've got liquid nitrogen that's about -196 degrees. In there is something that's called a superconductor. Superconductor is something, there we go, that gets incredibly cool when it gets incredibly cold, if that makes sense.
Okay.
But it also repels electrical or magnetic fields.
Okay.
So what we have here is a ring of magnets. So if I put it here, it's gonna float. And we think this is what Santa is doing with his sled. So it is floating because the Earth has a magnetic field around it.
So you conclude the whole thing mm-hmm. by not necessarily thinking Santa is magic,
mm-hmm.
but that he's a magic scientist.
He is a magical scientist.